Ophodiptera eucalypti, also known as the eucalyptus gum moth, is a big species of emperor moth found in New Zealand and Australia. They are easy to breed in theory, but despite that, I have never succeeded in completing the life cycle of this species yet. This is frustrating because seeing the fully grown caterpillars is a dream of mine. And one of the reasons why I may have failed in my several attempts before is because I haven't actually used or at least tried to use their original and best food plant, eucalyptus. Although I have tried to raise them before on sweet gum, liquid amber, and betula, birch tree, which was, so to say, a failure. The reason I haven't tried to use eucalyptus yet is because I don't have access to this food plant in Europe. So perhaps I am thinking of going to a garden center very soon and planting myself a nice supply of winter hardy species of eucalyptus, like the eucalyptus gunny, I believe it's called, like blue gum, I don't know. But this is one species of eucalyptus that grows very well in our temperate European climate. The fully grown caterpillars of this moth are simply amazing, so it's still on my to-do list for some time. It's just one of those species that's easy in theory, but that's just my weakness, you know. Breeding moths is not an easy hobby, and people tend to think that I'm some sort of moth god that automatically breeds everything he tries, but it's not true. I have failures too behind the scenes. I don't like to flaunt them on YouTube, and this species is really still one of my nemesis species. So I haven't had much success with these difficult emperors. I think if you live in Australia or New Zealand, these are very easy if you have all the good food plants in your area and the right temperature and humidity, etc. But outside of this continent, it will be harder. Another interesting thing is they can stay in their cocoons for a very long time. The female I'm holding on my hand right now, she stayed in her cocoons for 2 years before hatching. So yeah, let's show her cute little face here. It's okay. She's a bit of an old specimen. I don't think she has that long to live, but these moths are very short-lived. Anyways, thanks for watching my epic blog video update thingy. And until next time.